Hi everyone, this is Om from Civil Center. Welcome to our channel. As we know, Civil Center is continuously working with the vision to guide civil engineering students and professionals. And for that, we keep making videos on different software and on different topics related to civil engineering field. So, what are we going to learn today? So today we are going to learn how to do the modeling of the plinth beam. So we have already modeled this much in the last video, and today we are going to learn a few more things related to the modeling of the plinth beam. So we will start with it, but before that, let's open the structural drawing first, and we have to cleanly observe the structural drawing. So we are starting with the observation of the structural drawing over here. So this is the plinth beam layout, and we have to model the plinth beam according to this one. Okay, so we are going to just open the plan view of plan 609 because we have our plinth beam over here. Okay, so we will start with this one, and we will cast the roof beam on the plan 3658. Okay, so that's the height of the building, that is the floor to floor height on the first floor. Now we are going to see, we have four columns, that is of C7 type, and we will check out the dimension for that. It is 250 by 300. Okay, so the cross section of the column is defined. Now we have F6 type of footing over here. So we also have to cast the footing because we have not modeled the footing over here. So now I will open it parallelly so that I can easily model. So we will start with the modeling of the column. So first of all, I will specify the cross section, material, and the top and the bottom height of the column. Okay, so now we have to place this column. So I will just pick the correct grid line and I will place it at the point intersection. And it doesn't matter in which direction it is being modeled because we can always rotate it. So if you will start like this, then it may take some of the time whenever you are placing a new column or beam or any new structural member over here. So all my columns are placed properly, and now I have to just rotate it in order to get it in the proper orientation. So you can always do the rotation, or you can just change the size and it will rotate itself. Now I will simply move it outside the plinth beam that is already over here. Okay, now I will start casting the plinth beam. So we know the size of the plinth beam is 300 by 250 over here. So I will simply show you how you can cast a poly beam over here. However, we are not going to use this in this project. So I will simply remove it. It is just to show you that how you can cast it. Now that my purpose is done, then I can simply get rid of this beam and I will go for single beam. Okay, so I will start with midpoint to midpoint for all this, and then I will simply move the plinth beams that I have just modeled over here. Now it is in the perfect position. What is the next step? I will again have to check my structural drawing where I will see it. So in the 3D view, you can see this has been modeled at the wrong height. Okay, because we have modeled it in the wrong plan. So I can always move it to the desired direction. So what you can do, I will go to edit, then choose the move tool, and from there I can simply pick the point that I have to move, and I will simply drag it to the desired point, or I can simply choose the correct height. So I will calculate the correct height of that. So it is coming over here, 3349. Okay, so I have to simply select the move tool, then I will go to move linear, pick the point, and then I will assign the height. Okay, so I also need to show the direction for the same. So I am again repeating the process. What is this? Choose the move tool, pick the point, assign the direction, and then enter the value. So since we are moving in the downward direction, so you don't have to mark minus over there. So I will enter the value positive 3499. Okay, so that was the value that we have to assign, and now you can see it has been displaced 300 meter below. So what we need to do, we will select all of this and we will simply drag it to the desired location. Okay, so I will move it 300 mm upwards, and now it is perfectly placed. So we can also zoom in and see whether it is perfectly placed or not. So now it is perfectly placed over here. Now what we need to do, we need to model the rest of the beams, and in this video we are going to complete the modeling of the plinth beam. So guys, if you are liking this video and if you are learning from it, then hit the like button, share it with your friends and colleagues, and subscribe to our channel. Okay, now we will continue with this one. Okay, so we need to see what are the other things that are there in our structural drawing, and accordingly we will start modeling it. So I'm not going to place the footing now, but if you want to place the footing, then you will have to simply go to the footing and assign it. How to do that, I have already completed in my previous videos. Now I will go for the plinth beams. So first of all, I will just make a little bit of changes in my structural drawing so that I can have a proper visibility of the beams that are present over here. So I will select all my beams and assign it to a different layer which is of white color, so that I can simply get a proper view over here. Okay, so you can see now I have a proper view of the same. Now I can simply start with modeling. So I will take the reference from my structural drawing and I will start modeling the rest of the beams that are present over here. Okay, so let's place the rest of the beams. So you need to keenly observe your structural drawing in order to do the modeling. So for the one time you may miss some of the beams or the columns, so that's not an issue. Take a break of like 10 to 15 minutes while doing all these things, and after that you can continue your work. Now you can see we have the plinth beam exactly as we have in our structural drawing. So we have already modeled the plinth beam over here, and in the next video or in the next class we are going to learn how to just model the roof beams in Tekla structures. So guys, that was all for today. If you want more such informative videos, then you can visit our YouTube channel, as well as you can also visit our Facebook page, where you will find a number of YouTube videos and the informative posts related to our live online classes. So if you want to register for our live online classes, then you can simply go to the link given in the description. All you have to do is to click on that link and it will open up a Google form for you. You have to just fill your details over here and I will personally give you a call and I will guide you how to proceed to join our live classes. See you in the next video. Thank you.